Good afternoon,
welcome, sir.
So today we want to discuss about the the water harvesting structure. So earlier classes we have so you know about the framework of the soil and water conservational measures in a different land use systems. We have the for the effective conservation of the rainwater. So we have to categorize the land or the catchment area into a three important categories. One is arable land, another one is the non-arable land, and third category of a land is a land having the drainage line. That means it consists of gullies and nalas. Did you clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the basic framework. So and also we have discussed the different conservational measures for the different category of a land. So we have already discussed what are all the different conservational measures we have to adapted in the cultivated land, and what are all the different conservational measures we have to adapted for the non cultivated land, that is non cultivated or non arable land. And also some of the important the conservational measures which are to control the erosion and also stabilization of the gullies. So we have the other type of category of a conservational measures. Okay, clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So now, so we have the conservational one aspect. So I think already we have discussed some of the conservational measures: contour cultivation, contour bunding, graded water strips, graded strips, and also both agronomical measures and also the conservation, what is that, mechanical or the engineering measures. Okay. So the situation, just you also think of. So in a given situation, so there is a land of the cultivated land. Your land is all whatever the your land you have delineated. It is having all the three category. In this three category, you can find it the land which is suitable for the cultivation. That is arable land. Okay. So you have identified the cultivated land. So in that you have to adapt the different conservational measures. So this is one part. This is one part of the cultivated land or the arable land treatment. So something what happens? I told you the area is the receiving rainfall. The rainfall received in that particular area, it is not uniform. So take an example. Take the different agroclimatic regions. So if you are taken the consideration of the precipitation or the rainfall in the different agroclimatic condition is varies. Did you agree? Divya? KC Divya?
Yes, sir.
Is it agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have the land or the regions. You can find it some agroclimatic regions. So that is comprising of a different talukas, number of talukas. So in that agroclimatic zone or in a given region, the distribution of rainfall or the distribution of precipitation is not uniform in the entire area. Okay, so this is one. The second point, so when there is in some area it receives very less rainfall, there you can very much need of the conservational measures. Is it clear? Dheeraj? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is, so you have the land or the region which is receives variation in the rainfall situation. Variation in the rainfall. So in that case, what happens? Some area receives the less rainfall and some area which is received more rainfall. So there are two to the situations occur where the land which is receives very small amount of less amount of precipitation, there you need the more of conservational measures. Is it clear? Did you clear? So in some situation what happens, so there is a higher more rainfall in that area. So what happens, you have to conserve the rainwater as well as you can go for disposing the excess runoff water as the rainwater. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Please. Okay. So that is wherever the area which is receives higher rainfall, so the both the conservation of the rainfall is also required. At the same time, if it is excess water, that is nothing but excess rainwater, that is nothing but the runoff. That runoff can be safely disposed from a given catchment area. That is the another situation that you have to take into care. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In that situation, what happens? In a land of a given area, you have the cultivated land. So you have demarcated a small area of one or two hectares. So in that area, so if it is a rainfall is received higher, more rainfall received, in that situation, you have to conserve as much as possible. And the remaining excess water is to be collected and safely taken to store the water in a water harvesting structure. Did you clear?
Repeat, sir. Yes.
Okay. Yes. Then, so that area you have to delineate it and conserve it. And if it is a excess water, that will be taken and safely through the waterways, and stored in the water harvesting structure, so that is for the further use. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So whatever excess water is taken by the safe disposal and collected and stored in the whatever the water that is collected from the cultivated land, remember, whatever the excess water that will be excess rainwater collected from the cultivated land and stored in the water harvesting structures like param pond. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
So whatever the water you have collected from the cultivated land and stored in a water harvesting structure, that structure is known as param pond. So that param pond is a water harvesting structure. You have to go for digging or constructing in a cultivated land. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
So there are two kinds of param pond. One is a impounding type, another one is the dugout type. So here there is a difference between these two. So just assume that. So if you have the area, you having some depressed area in the your delineated area. So take an example, if you have 2 hectares of land. So in that 2 hectares of land, some area is a down, that is some depression in that particular area. So you can use that depression area for the just to put the earth embankment across this slope in the depressed area, so it will be the water is stored in that place. That kind of water, the param pond, you can say it is impounding type of water harvesting structure, impounding type of param pond, where there is your depression area is to be checked by the earthen embankment, constructed by the earthen embankment, and store the excess rainwater which is collected from the cultivated land. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
So next, another tank. So there is no depressed area. You need to store the water which is dug out a pond just below the surface. So such kind of the param ponds are excavated, dug out type. This is a second type of param pond. The dug out type of param pond are excavated type of param pond. Did you clear? Please.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
This is the basic concept. All of you remember.
Excuse me, sir. So
please, where is that? Other people's? Other
me,
other guys? Yeah, please.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, yeah, tell me.
Sir, in first one, impounding type of pond, embankment type, it is naturally made or it is man-made, sir?
It is naturally depressed area is to be identified and just to put the earthen embankment across the slope. To store, it is to scope the storage of water in that depressed area.
Okay, sir.
Just to, you can identify the naturally depressed area and put it some embankment across the slope, thereby it will be stored the maximum water in that depressed area. So you can use that water for the further use. Is it clear? Please, is it clear? Somebody is asking.
Yes, sir, go on.
Okay. So this is one. The whenever there is no depressed area, but if you want to go for storing the water in a low-lying area or in a downstream side of your catchment, you can go for dugout type of param pond. Dugout type, I will explain how you have to go for, how to select, and also what the criteria you have to take into consideration for the digging of a param pond in the lower stream. Okay, downstream. Okay, clear? Now, this yes, concept sir. Is clear? Concept is clear?
Yes, sir.
Please, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You can see here, this is the, just to, they have find it at the depressed area, the storage area they have marked here, it is a depressed area, they have find it, and just below this, they have providing this the earthen embankment. Earthen embankment, so this will be constructed across this slope. Just here, I will show you here. Just a moment. So, see here. From this side, you have this slope. We have the slope. This is the slope side direction. So, where there is this earthen embankment is constructed here. Okay, this is the earthen embankment constructed, and all other different components we have to provide it. What other components? The emergency spillway is provided. The emergency spillway, it is provided just below the level of water which is stored in the param pond, impounding pond. So why? Because that to avoid the breaking of earthen embankment, we have to provide this emergency spillway for the disposal of excess water which is stored in the param pond. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
So the terminology we use here, the mechanical spillway. This is the mechanical spillway we have to provide where there is a need of water is to be dried out from the param pond and utilized for the other purposes. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, unfortunately, emergency spillway is used whenever there is a heavy rain and also the unexpected water is to be stored in that place. So, that is used for the excess disposal of water stored in the param pond. So, this mechanical spillway, it is used for the use of water, the stored water for the further use by means of by taking the water from the mechanical spillway and use it for the other different purposes. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In this way, this is a kind of the impounding type of water harvesting structure, that is Param pond, which is constructed in the cultivated land and use this water for the beneficial purposes. I will explain later on. Okay. Did you clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See here, this is the waterway we have already shown in the previous classes. This is the stabilized waterway. Is it clear? See here, right hand side, you can find it a number of the land which are bifurcated, fragmented lands are the different land, the whole land is divided into some the parts are smaller holdings. So in that area, what happens, there is a slope is towards like this. Just to assume that the slope is here. Just a moment. See here, slope is in this direction. Is it not? The slope is in this direction. Okay. So the grass and waterways are always provided, constructed across, all along this slope by providing checks. See here, there is a one check here. So there is a one check and there is another check. And like that, a series of checks are provided in the grassed waterway during, it will help to reduce. Why the purpose is? Tell me why they have to put these checks, mechanical barrier or the mechanical checks in the grassed waterways? Anyone? Bhavana? Yeah, please, anyone?
To reduce the velocity or the velocity of water, sir.
So see here. So when there is a waterway is constructed all along the slope. So what happens? The velocity of the runoff water that is moving in the waterway is increases. When there is a the velocity of the water increases, what happens again? It will be starting the scoring of soil or the making the erosions. So to reduce the velocity of the flowing water in the grassed waterway, so waterway, you have to put the mechanical checks at a regular interval. Did you clear? Ankit? Ankit?
Yes, sir.
Ankita? Ankita?
Yes, sir.
Did you clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, all of you, please.
Yes, sir.
Very nice. Very nice. So, to avoid what is the purpose of putting the mechanical checks in the grassed waterways? So, to reduce the velocity of the flowing water, and also at the same time, you can observe here. So, there is a person sitting on the upper mechanical check. So, in between the two checks, there is a soil is accumulated here. See here, soil is accumulated here. So this soil is what happens, the entire water, flowing water carries along the soil is carried along with the water, and where there is a velocity is here stops or reduces. So during that time, whatever the silt or the soil which is carried along with the water, that will be deposited here. Deposited here. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
So when there is a deposition of this, the silt, the water, this waterway is stabilized, and it will be stabilized, and thereby the water is moving at a non-erosive velocity. Did you clear, Bhavana?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
So this water is moving with a non-erosive velocity and moving downward, and also collected this water in where we have to collect? Where we have to collect? We have to collect it in water harvesting structure like Dhiraj.
Param pond.
Yes. See here. So this water is always this water is collected in par, this param pond. Did it clear?
Yes, sir.
Very nice. So we have collected this water, okay? And that water is excess water. That is only the excess water after conservational of the maximum rain water. The excess water is to be taken and with a safe disposal, safe velocity, we will collect that water in the param pond. Did you clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
So there is a criteria. There is a criteria for the selection of this site for the construction of param pond. There are 4 or 5 major criteria we have to take into consideration. The first one is the location of the I think illi yavudu nanu I don't have any note mentioned here. So just to assume, very important, the 5 criteria for the selection of site for the construction of param pond. The first one is, it should be always, the site should be at the lower elevated place. This is the first one. Second one, lower elevated place, lower catchment area. Where there is your catchment, the lowest point you have to select it for the construction of digging of the param pond. One, first one. Second one. So the selected site, it must be impermeable. The soil must be impermeable in nature. So that is, it will helps to hold the water without seepage loss. Did you clear? Second one. Did you clear? Dheeraj.
Sir, repeat, sir.
Please. Repeat, madam.
Sir.
I will give you, because you have this more of this ICR and also the other students. Kannada local, everything you can understand. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಏರಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಆ ಸೈಟು, ಅದು ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಡೌನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಒಂದು ಎರಡನೇದು, ಆ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ನೀರು ಬಸ್ತು ಹೋಗಬಾರ್ದು, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೀಪೇಜ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಜಾಗ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ಎರಡು, ಮೂರನೇದು ದಿ ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಡೆಪ್ತ್ 5 ಮೀಟರ್ಗಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿನ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು. ಎಷ್ಟು? 3. ಅಂಡ್ 4ನೇದು, ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ದಿ 1:1 slope, side slope for the param pond. Nalakku and aidnedo, you have to at least, so what is that, you use the water at gravitational force. Whatever the stored water, it is used by the gravitational force. You 5 criteria you have to remember. I will repeat once again. Please remember, the important 5 criteria are followed to select the site for the construction of a param pond. The first one is, it should be, the site should always be at the lower elevated place. First one. Second one, so that selected site soil is to be impermeable in nature. Second one. Third one is, it should not be, depth is should not be more than 5 meter. Third one. Fourth one, we use that water for the through the gravitational force. Okay. And also the fifth one is, you provide the side slope for the pond is 1:1. 1:1 means, for every 1 meter vertical, you have to provide the 1 meter horizontal extra. So that will be, I will teach how during the designing aspect. Okay, did you clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 5 criteria, all of you. Okay. ICR guys, did you follow me?
Sir. Sir, how to use the water by gravitational force?
So you have to collect, you have the demarcated area of 1 hectare, you have the 2 hectares of land. So 1 hectare area, that is a place where you have this what is that the lowest point. Okay, you have still more the one or two hectares of area in the downstream of this pond, so you can use this water through the gravitationally to the your lowest catchment area. Did you clear,
sir? Andre ashton artha agila sir,
artha agila iga idindu jameen ide. So we have to selected land jaasti ide, jaasti iddaga ಒಂದು ಏರಿಯಾ ಒಂದು ಹೆಕ್ಟೇರ್ ನ ಬೈಫರ್ಕೇಶನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ಯಾ, ಆ ಒಂದು ಹೆಕ್ಟೇರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಡೌನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ಡೌನ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀಯಾ. ಸೊ ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೂ 4 ಎಕರೆ ಇದೆ ನಿಂದು, 4 ಹೆಕ್ಟೇರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದು ಇನ್ನೂ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀಯ ಆ ವಾಟರ್ ನ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಇರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋ ಅಂತ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್.
ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಸರ್?
ಈಗ ನಿಂದು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ನಿಂದು ಕುವೆಂಪು ಸಭಾಂಗಣದಿಂದ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಿಂದು ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ವರ್ಗೂ ನಿಂದೇ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡು. ಓಕೆ, ನೀನು ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ನಮ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್, ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ದಿ ಸೈಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಫಾರಂ ಪಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ನಿಮ್ದು ಹೊಲ ಇನ್ನು ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಈ ನೀರ್ನ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದ ನೀನು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ.
ಅದೇ ಹೆಂಗ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ ಸರ್, ಅದೇ ನನ್ ಡೌಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಅಯ್ಯೋ ದೇವ್ರೆ, ನಿಂದು ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟ ಹತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಹಳ್ಳ, ಎಷ್ಟು ದೂರದಲ್ಲಿದೆ?
ಡೌನ್ ಇದೆ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್.
ಅದನ್ನೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು, ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ, ಇದ್ರೆ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಹೋಗಿ ಅಂತಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ರೈಟೀರಿಯಾ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರೇಷನ್ ಟು ಮಿನಿಮೈಸ್ ದಿ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೈ. ಈಗ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಾಧ್ಯನೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಸೇವಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಸಂತೆಗೆ. ನೀನ್ ಸಂತೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇರೋದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ 4 ಅಕ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೇನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ
ಸರ್? ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್.
ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಅದೇ, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ರೈಟೀರಿಯಾ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್, ಲಿವ್ ಇಟ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ವೇ.
ಸರ್
Did you clear? Yeah, please tell me. Dilip, 5 meter in the depth, yeah, kirbar sir, jaasti. I will come to that point. If you want to go for the more depth, what happens, you know that the hydraulic pressure which is created, hydraulic pressure, the whatever the water that is stored, so when there is a more than 5 meter, if the hydraulic pressure increases, when there is a hydraulic pressure increases, it will be pushes the more pressure on the water. So the more and more water is to be infiltrated and seep into the down. So immediately what happens, whatever the water you are selecting, whatever the water storage capacity, there will be storage volume is decreases. So that is not directly benefited to you. That is why you can minimize at least for the sake of use of that water harvested water for about 2 to 3 months.
Okay sir, thank you.
Okay.
Sir,
okay, next. You don't worry, you tell me, you can ask me, don't worry, I will clarify that if I know, otherwise I will refer and tell you. Okay, no worry
sir. And what about the scientific reason behind that slope sir? Should be 1:1 ratio.
Otherwise what happens if the water is storing, the soil, sides, side wall is wetted, the scoring of soil inside the what is that, param pond, and ultimately it will be what happens, continuously scoring of soil due to the water storage, it will be filled,
decreases.
Yeah, ultimately that will be.
But the water, there is a stagnant water alla sir, angiddaga erosion hang agutte?
Erosion allappa, gadde nendu kolegadik bidd hogutte mannu
sir. Gotaichu sir.
4 kodenu ella kada neer nindkondu neernalli ಬಾವಿ ಬಾವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು ಬಾವಿ ಚೌಕಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ನೆಂದು 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 ಬಡೆ ಮುಚ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಿಂದೇನಾಗ್ತೈತೆ ಅದು ದೊಡ್ಡದೊಂದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಊರಿನ ಕೆರೆ ಆಗೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಏನೋ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಹೊರಟೋಗುತ್ತೆ
ಮಾಡಿದಾಗೂ ಗಡ್ಡೆ ನೆಂದು ಒಳಗಡೆ ಬೀಳುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಅವಾಗ ಕೂಡ
ಈಗ ನನ್ ಕೈ ನನ್ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಲ್ಲ ನನ್ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಲ್ಲ
ಹಾ ಸರ್
ಹಿಂಗಿದ್ರೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಎತ್ತ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ಗೆ
ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಹೆಂಗಾದ್ರೂ ನೆಂದು ಬಿದ್ದೆ ಬೀಳುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ
ಓ ಸಾರಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಒಂದ್ ನೋಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿನ್ ಮನೆ ಇದಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಿಯಲ್ಲ ಹೊಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಿಯಲ್ಲ ಹಾಗೆ ತೆಗ್ದು ನೋಡು ಹಾಗೆನ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕು ಯಾವ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿದ್ದೋಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನಗೆ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳು
ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಇದು ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಬಾವಿ ತೆಗಿಯಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ನಿಂತ್ ಕೂತ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸೊ ಈ ಟೈಮ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದು 40 ನಿಮಿಷ ಒಂದ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಇಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಗುಂಡಿ ತೆಗ್ದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ತೋರಿಸಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಆಗಿ ನಿನ್ಗೆ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್
ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್
ಅದನ್ನ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಬಿರೇಶ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡೌಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೂ ನೀನ್ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು 30 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ನ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತೆಗೆದು ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕು ಮಣ್ಣು ಹೆಂಗ ಹೋಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು 30 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಅಗಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಕೊಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ನ ಕೊಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿದ್ದೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನ
ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಡಗ್ಔಟ್ ಫಾರಂ ಪಾಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಔಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಫಾರಂ ಪಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ರೆಕ್ಟಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಒನ್ ಬಟ್ ಟ್ರೆಪೆಜಾಯ್ಡಲ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರೆಪೆಜಾಯ್ಡಲ್ ಬಟ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಇಸ್ ರೆಕ್ಟಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್
ಸರ್
ಈಗ ದಿಲೀಪ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಜಿ ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸೀ ದಿಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿ ಬಾಟಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪರಂ ಪಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಫೋರ್ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ
Yes, sir.
Clear?
So, yes, sir.
So this is one where you can find it here. This is the bottom of this pond. Okay? This is the one side and this is another side and this is third side. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Ankita Verma, where are you?
Sir, I am here only. Yes, sir, it's clear, sir.
You are there only. Okay, no problem. So, clear? So, these are the four sides. This is the bottom. Okay? So, I will tell you the dimension. You can just assume that. So, here, from ear to ear, this is a square one. Shape is trapezoidal. Shape is a trapezium and the size is square. Remember? Okay? Did you clear? Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, from ear to ear, see here, Biresh, listen. Illi nodi. Nama
ah, sir.
ಅವನು ಇವನ್ ಎತ್ತೋದ್ನಪ್ಪ ಅತ್ರಿ ಏನೋ ಏನೋ ಅವನ ಯಾರ ಇವನಪ್ಪ ಇದ್ದಲ್ಲ ಕೇರಳದನು ಎ ಇಂದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡು ಆ ಅತ್ರಿ ಏನೋ ಎಂತ ನಾನು ಅದಾಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೋದ ಅವನು ಟೀ ಕುಡಿಯಕ್ಕೆ ನಡೀದು ಹುಡುಗಿಯರ್ ವಾಯ್ಸನ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಯಾಕೆ ಗರ್ಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೋ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಇವತ್ತು ಯಾರ್ದು ಇಲ್ವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ತಿಂಡಿ ಗಿಂಡಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಾಯ್ತೋ ಇಲ್ವೋ ಏನ್ ಕಥೆನೋ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬರ್ತೀನಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಪರ ಓಕೆ 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 ಸೊ ಡಿಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಯಾರ್ದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿಲ್ಲ That is embankment is that is what is that the impounding type is just to put the other embankment naturally wherever there is a deepened area so you can just to put the earthen embankment across this slope just water is storing in front of this embankment okay this is one here this is the second type so see here this is the second type dug out just below the surface of the water surface of the land did you clear
yes sir
so that is above the surface this is below the surface this is the above the surface just to put the earth embankment okay this is
a so both are compounds only no sir
yeah, both are compounds yeah, that is a impounding type this is a dug out type
oh yes okay sir yes so
Okay, did it clear? Okay, is it okay? Okay, so this is one. You have the different components. See here, there is a see here. See here, this is the inlet. This is the inlet. Okay, so Is it audible? Audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is an inlet. There are three components. One is, what is that? This is inlet, and this side you can't see. I will show you in another photograph. So this side there is a outlet. Outlet, inlet. This is an inlet, and this is the outlet. Okay. This is inlet. This is inlet, and this is outlet. Okay. This is outlet. Okay. This is a storage area. You can have the storage area. So you have this storage area. The volume. It's a volume. This volume can be calculated by using formula. We can use this formula and find it the the storage, the capacity of the palm pond with a trapezoidal shape. Trapezoidal shape. So you can use this V is equal to capital A plus capital that is 4 times of the capital B plus capital C divided by so 6 whole divided by 6 whole divided by 6. So, and this was multiplied by this whole multiplied by the depth D. Okay. So, in this way, you have to calculate, use this formula to calculate the volume of a param pond. Volume of a param pond. Okay. Prismoidal formula, we can say it is a, this is a prismoidal formula. V is equal to A capital A plus 4 capital B plus C whole divided by 6 multiplied by D, that is the depth of param pond. So where V, that is always V is 1, the volume of a param pond, it is in cubic meter. V is in cubic meter. And A is the cross-sectional area. It is cross-sectional area of param pond at top. This is the top where this is B is represented. Same thing, but at the mid. At middle, and the C is, it is similar, so that is same thing at bottom. Okay, at bottom, and at bottom, and D is, what is that? D is equal to depth of param pond in meters. All in area, that is cross sectional area, is in square meter. A is in square meter. And B is in square meter, C is also in square meter, and D is in meter. Okay. So finally, V can be calculated by using the volume. Okay. This is the capacity of the param pond. We can find it. Okay. Did it clear? All of you?
Yes, sir.
So any doubt about this, please? See, V is equal to volume of parampound capacity. Parampound is calculated by using A plus 4B plus prismoidal formula. It is a prismoidal formula. A plus 4B plus C divided by 6 into D, whereas V is equal to volume of a parampound in cubic meter, and A is nothing but the cross-sectional area at the top of the parampound, and B is representing the cross-sectional area at the top. Here, see here, just a moment, I will tell you, where is that, this is the top, where is that, yeah, just a moment, see here. This is the top cross-sectional area at the top, and this is the middle of the parampond. This is the cross-sectional area at the middle, and this is the cross-sectional area at the bottom. So A is represented the cross-sectional area at the top. So that is the top area, length and width. And for this middle of the middle cross-sectional area of the parampond is at middle of the pond, and that is middle of the length and width of the at middle of the pond, and bottom, the this is the cross-sectional area at the bottom of the parampond, that is width, bottom width and bottom length. So I have given here bottom width and also bottom length. So you can use this equation formula and find it the volume of a given parampond. Okay, yeah. Did you clear, all of you?
Yes sir.
Yes, sir. I will give you 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes assignment. You can tell me the, so you have to find it the cross sectional area of the parampond which is having some different dimensions. So A is equal to, this A is equal to 12 meter. This is 12 meter and 12 meter. This is cross square, no? 12 meter. Okay. 2 minutes. You have to find it and tell me the volume. Okay. This is 12 meter by 12 meter. Okay. Bottom is 6 meter into 6 meter. This is 6 meter into 6 meter. This is a, for all of you, 6 meter into 6 meter. D depth is 3 meter. D is equal to 3 meter. Yeah, tell me the volume immediately. Quickly, 3 meter. Yeah, tell me. V is equal to A plus 4B plus C divided by 6 into multiplied by D. Chaitra, I will ask you. This is the last slide. Quickly.
Sir, middle is to, sir.
Middle, you can take this average. Top. Take the average of this top and bottom. Average of top and bottom. How much it is? Middle?
9, sir.
Yes, very nice. 9 by 9, not 9. 9 meter width and 9 meter length. Is it clear? Quickly. I have one more class. Bega.
Two seventy-two meter cube.
Two?
Sir, 252, sir.
Two?
252, sir.
Where is
252, sir. 252, sir.
You got 252, one other fellow? Hey, tell me, I don't know the exact. I will check it and tell you. Yeah, please. Really? Hello, Toido. I think. Yeah. Ankit Verma.
Sir, I have got 252. I am getting, sir.
Oh, you getting 252 is it's all.
Yes.
Okay. Any other? Bhavani.
252, sir.
Chaitra.
252 meter cube, sir.
Chaitra.
Sir, 252.
Very nice. Noda na inno. Yakandre 2 into 2 multiplied by 2 is 3 sometime. 2 multiplied by 2 is 4 sometime. 2 multiplied by 2 is 5 sometime. So that's the different the values, no? So let us see how Victor. What are you doing, Victor? Yen Martha idiya? Victor. Yeah. 130? Yeah, tell me. So exactly wrong. Absolutely wrong.
Sir, 272 meter cube, sir.
Absolutely wrong.
Sir, 252 meter cube, sir.
Yeah, exactly correct.
252, sir.
Yes, 252. A is a cross-sectional area 12 by 12 meter and B is 4 tenths of the middle one. So 4 into multiplied by B is 9 by 9, that is 81. 4 tenths of the 81 plus C is 36, that is 6 by 6, 36 divided by 6 times and multiplied by your 3, depth is 3. You can get this 252 cubic meter. This is the capacity of the Param pond is recommended. Remember, it is recommended. Remember, it is recommended. Remember, so 1 hectare area is the capacity is recommended is 250. 250 is the capacity of the Param pond is required for 1 hectare area. Remember. So if you want to go for the Param pond of 250 cubic meter, this is the dimension with a square trapezium with depth of 3 meter by providing 1:1 slope. Did you clear all of you? Did you clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
So any doubt, please ask me. I will close this session. Today's session I will close. Any yes, doubt? Any doubt, please, sir?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Yeah, tell me. 90 members are present. I'm very lucky. Okay, very good. So, if you have any, this is, I will, in 2 minutes, I will complete this entire, the whole picture. So, in a cultivated land, there is a more rainfall, the excess rainwater that is runoff is to be stored in the watershed, the water harvesting structures like Param pond in the cultivated land. So there are two categories. One is impounding type of pond and the second one is the dugout pond. So the impounding type of pond is just to identify the depressed area in a location. You can just put the earthen embankment across the slope. You can store the water and use it, that water, for the other purposes. Second, the second type, the dugout type. So there are, you can find the, you can find the, you can find the different consider the different criteria, important 5 criteria for the selection of the perm pond dugout type of a pond, because so that is beneficial for the further use. Whatever the water stored in the pond is beneficially economically used for the other purposes. So that dugout ponds is 5 the design criteria, and also the capacity of the different functional components in the perm pond is inlet, outlet, and also the storage area. So this is the one, and also where there is a conduct is there to give the passage and safely carry out the excess water. These are the functional component, and earthen embankment. Components which are included. So there is a berm. We have to provide space, 1 meter berm, and also you can put the earthen embankment all round the perm pond. Okay, you can use this 1 hectare capacity, 1 hectare area. It is needed 250 cubic meter capacity of a pond in red soil regions. In red soil regions, and also in same thing is in for the black soil, but the side slope for the red soil is 1:1. For one vertical interval, there is a one vertical horizontal interval is to be provided. And in the black soil area, for every one vertical interval, you have to provide the 2 horizontal interval. That is, for every 1 meter, you have to provide the 2 meter horizontal interval. So if there is a more slope, side slope for the black soil because of clay soil. Okay, so that is why you have to provide. Okay. So this is how we have to use this prismatic formula to calculate the volume of a perm pond. Did you clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, one and all. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.